The Brewers knew sweeping the Cubs this weekend wouldn't be easy, especially since they were playing Game 3 shorthanded. Both Gene Segura and Ryan Braun out with injuries. Segura recovering from being hit in the head with a bat during last night's game, and Braun dealing with an intercostal strain. It was Carlos Gomez bobblehead day at Miller Park, and this young fan was overcome with emotion to meet her favorite baseball player before the game. Look at her. Can't help but cry after hugging Gomez. Wow. Unfortunately, those tears of joy turned to sadness once the game started. Willie Peralta trying for his fourth win of the season, but didn't look good today. Gives up a solo shot to Starlin Castro to center field in the second inning. Cubs take a 1-0 lead. Same inning, Peralta loads the bases, and then Aroma Ramirez gets the out at third. But his thrown home to Jonathan Lucroy is not even close, and Chicago scores again. Makes it 2-0, Gomez playing a little sloppy on his bobblehead day with two on for one in the Cubs in the sixth. Gomez makes the catch. Runner on third tags up and scores. However, Gomez's throw to third is way off base. He wasn't happy about that. But Gomez at least breaks up the Cubs' no-hitter in the sixth. The Brewers finally get a hit off of starting pitcher Jason Hammel when Gomez doubles down the line, but not much brewing for Milwaukee today. They score zero runs. Meanwhile, Chicago adds to their lead in the eighth. Second home run of the game for Starlin Castro. Brewers don't get the weekend sweep, but fall to the Cubs 4-0.
That was really good. I mean, he's got a really good fastball that he spots well. And his two breaking ball pitches are really good. His slider and curveball are really good pitches.
It's really, really tough. So, you know, yes, we get out there and do the best and put a good contact and, you know, give it credit. He got a good game today. And the next time, I wish we have better luck.
Marquette lost two basketball recruits over the weekend. According to JS Online, Ahmad Hill and Satchel Pierce, who had signed scholarships to play for the Golden Eagles this coming fall, are now headed to Virginia Tech to play for former MU head coach Buzz Williams. So far, Seymour Sandy Cohen is the only member of Marquette's 2014 freshman class who honored his commitment to play for the Golden Eagles. In NBA playoff action today, Wizards hosting the Bulls in D.C., a game you saw earlier right here on WISN 12, big day for Trevor Ariza, scores a career playoff high 30 points. Wizards now lead the series 3-1. They are looking to win a playoff series for only the third time since the 1970s. Game 5 is Tuesday night in Chicago. And finally, so much for home ice advantage in the playoffs. The Admirals fall to Toronto Marlins again last night at the BMO Harris Bradley Center. They lose 5-2. Milwaukee is down 2-0 in the best of 5 series, which now heads to Toronto for Game 3. Here's head coach after last night's game.
You know, you just look back to last year. We won 3 in a row to get into the playoffs by 1 point. You know, we've got a group that all year we talked about one game at a time, and the next game, this one's done.
I'm Maurice Childs. That's it for Big 12 Sports. Brewers knew sweeping the Cubs this weekend wouldn't be easy, especially since they were playing Game 3 shorthanded. Both Gene Segura and Ryan Braun out with injuries. Segura recovering from being hit in the head with a bat during last night's game, and Braun dealing with an intercostal strain. It was Carlos Gomez bobblehead day at Miller Park, and this young fan was overcome with emotion to meet her favorite baseball player before the game. Look at her. Can't help but cry after hugging Gomez. Wow. Unfortunately, those tears of joy turned to sadness once the game started. Willie Peralta trying for his fourth win of the season but didn't look good today. Gives up a solo shot to Starlin Castro to center field in the second inning. Cubs take a 1-0 lead. Same inning, Peralta loads the bases, and then Aramis Ramirez gets the out at third, but his thrown home to Jonathan Lucroy is not even close, and Chicago scores again. Makes it a 2-0. Gomez playing a little sloppy on his bobblehead day with two on the Cubs in the sixth. Gomez makes the catch, runner on third, tags up and scores. However, Gomez's throw to third is way off base. He wasn't happy about that. Gomez at least breaks up the Cubs no-hitter in the sixth. The Brewers finally get a hit off. Starting pitcher Jason Hamill when Gomez doubles down the line. But not much brewing for Milwaukee today. They score zero runs. Meanwhile, Chicago adds to their lead in the eighth. Second home run. Stop. All right. Brewers knew sweeping the Cubs this weekend wouldn't be easy, especially since they were playing Game 3 shorthanded. Both Gene Segura and Ryan Braun out with injuries, Segura recovering from being hit in the head with a bat during last night's game, and Braun dealing with an intercostal strain. It was Carlos Gomez bobblehead day at Miller Park, and this young fan was overcome with emotion to meet her favorite baseball player before the game. Look at her, but can't help but cry after hugging Gomez. So sweet. Unfortunately, those tears of joy turned to sadness once the game started. Willie Peralta trying for his fourth win of the season but didn't look good today. Gives up a solo shot to Starlin Castro to center field in the second inning. Cubs take a 1-0 lead. Same inning, Peralta loads the bases, and then Ramirez gets the out at third. But his thrown home to Jonathan Lucroy, not even close, and Chicago scores again. Makes it a 2-0. Gomez playing a little sloppy on his bobblehead day with two on for the Cubs in the sixth. Gomez makes the catch. Runner on third, tags up and scores. However, Gomez's throw to third is way off base. He wasn't happy about that. Gomez at least breaks up the Cubs no-hitter in the sixth. The Brewers finally get a hit off. Starting pitcher Jason Hamill when Gomez doubles down the line, but not much brewing for Milwaukee today. They score zero runs. Meanwhile, Chicago adds to their lead in the eighth, second home run of the game for Starlin Castro. Brewers don't get the weekend sweep. They fall to the Cubs 4-0.
That was really good. I mean, he's got a really good fastball that he spots well. And his two breaking ball pitches are really good. His slider and curveball are really good pitches.
It's really, really tough. So, you know, yes, we get out there and do the best and pretty good contact. And, you know, give it credit. He got a good game today. And the next time, I wish we have better luck.
Marquette lost two basketball recruits over the weekend. According to JS Online, Ahmad Hill and Satchel Pierce, who had signed scholarships to play for the Golden Eagles this coming fall, are now headed to Virginia Tech to play for former Marquette head coach Buzz Williams. So far, Seymour Sandy Cohen is the only member of the Marquette's 2014 freshman class who has honored his commitment to play for the Golden Eagles. In NBA playoff action today, Wizards hosting the Bulls in D.C., a game you saw earlier right here on WISN 12. Big day for Trevor Ariza, scores a career playoff high 30 points. Wizard now lead the score 3-1. They are looking to win a playoff series for the third time since the 1970s. Game 5 is Tuesday night in Chicago. And finally, so much for home ice advantage in the playoffs. The Admirals fall to Toronto Marlins last night at the BMO Harris-Bradley Center. They lose 5-2. Milwaukee is down 2-0 in the best of 5 series, which now heads to Toronto for Game 3. Here's head coach after the game.
You know, you just look back to last year. We won 3 in a row to get into the playoffs by 1 point. You know, we've got a group that all year we talk about one game at a time, and the next game, this one's done.
This is Maurice Childs for Big 12 Sports.